if you're center, right of center, you know, it's sort of a little more nuanced. What's the prevailing idea of what people want to see this Congress do?
I think with a Congress that is so energized, and particularly with the Democratic House that really feels as though they have something to prove, the most that we can hope for here is for a Congress that's really going to focus on finding that common ground, finding an area where there is that bipartisan interest in making progress, such as foreign policy, criminal justice reform, things that we saw towards the end of 2018 that were making progress and where we still have a lot of room for continued cooperation.
And I think one of the issues that's going to come first and foremost once they get the government back open is the issue of immigration, because it seems as though that is an issue where you do have Republicans who favored doing something with DACA, not necessarily a full-on amnesty program, which a lot of Republicans have described it as, but they want to get something done, and that's an issue where there is some common ground. Is this the right political climate in which they can achieve that?
Absolutely. I think that there is an opportunity for a lot of continued progress when it comes to immigration reform. I think in terms of the DREAM Act and the state that it is now, I think it's probably likely that a Democratic House will try to pass that and push that forward. I think we'll see some gridlock there on the Senate side. But it will prove as a really interesting starting off point for a healthy debate on how we can reform immigration in a way that's safe for Americans, safe for legal immigrants, and also will move both parties' agendas forward in a helpful and profitable way.
And I think when you look at the dynamic of Congress the last several years, you had the Senate, which was more deliberative, where there was more compromise achieved. The House was more ideological when you had powerful forces like the Freedom Caucus and the Tea Party calling a lot of the shots for the Republican majority. Now you have the Democrats in control. Is there going to be a certain dynamic where you have the far left and you have some of the progressives who may be trying to push Nancy Pelosi, who we already know is pretty liberal, even more left, or is she going to moderate?
I think this is an opportunity for us to take one of two paths here. I think that this new Republican Senate and this more democratically controlled House can either really work towards making progress by pushing again towards those bipartisan issues that I mentioned earlier, or they can try to hit the ground running, feel that they have a point to prove to make up for the last 2 years or so, and really alienate some GOP or Republican congressmen who might otherwise have been more willing to cooperate with them. And I think that that would be a mistake on their part to try to make too much happen too quickly, as opposed to focusing on some of those areas that might be more appealing for both sides.
Rachel, one thing Republicans have learned when they impeached Bill Clinton years ago was that they paid a price politically down the road. Democrats, we know, there are some Democrats, not all, have said that that was one of their top priorities, to impeach President Trump. Is that something that really could backfire once again, in your estimation?
It would absolutely backfire. I think that any effort to impeach the president would be done not with the intention of that actually coming to fruition, and more so as sort of a political move on the Democrat side to symbolically gesture the kind of tone that they want to set for this Congress moving forward. That would be damaging to the American people and to both parties politically and for the health of the country moving forward.
And right before I let you go, your prediction, how much longer do you think both sides are going to stand their ground before they settle the shutdown?
I think that when it comes to President Trump, he has said since before his election that he is someone who is not afraid of conflict, is not afraid of tough negotiations, and I think that we're going to see a continued conflict until we have some more fluidity and some more wiggle room when it comes to building this wall.
And you know, the good news is it gives us something to talk about here on the Final Five. So, Rachel Tripp, it's good to see you. Thank you for saying.